our next guest has made a habit of screwing celebrities, but not in a Jodie Marsh kind of way. It's Olivia Lee. See you. Okay, guys. Olivia, it's great to have you on the show. You've brought company. What's going on?
Yeah, well, I thought I'd try something new this week, Mark. I've been working on a show called Deaf TV. This is my co-star, Mark Nelson. Now, he interviews celebrities by the medium of sign language, and I translate.
Okay, now, I didn't know that you could read sign language,
no,
Olivia.
No, I absolutely cannot. Mark just visually abuses the celebrities, and I make up questions so he doesn't get rumbled.
Well, that's more like it. Let's take a look.
Hello, welcome to Deaf TV. This is my new co-presenter, Mark. I told you, we haven't got any ice creams. Give it a rest already. You've done some acting recently. Mm. You did a film with Guy Ritchie.
Yeah.
What was that about?
I'm a waitress that goes around nicking everything. Very close to real life.
You're originally from Horsham, so did you play your character quite tongue-in-cheek?
Yeah, it was quite funny. Is that my food?
That's modelling. It's a compliment. I'm not a...
Rude.
No, he said, do you like dancing? Would you like to go dancing with him?
Yeah, let's go to a club together then.
There were lots of games on Love Island. Was that difficult, having to think off the top of your head?
You don't want to come across at all thick or anything like that when you're, you know, constantly on camera because you never know what they're going to show. But it was surprising how silly some of the other people were, really. He's swearing at me, isn't he? Okay.
Bing.
What's all that about?
That means he's a big fan.
Okay. I thought he was doing some rude gestures.
No, no, it's more literal. Very visual sign language.
Oh, I know, but it was, yeah.
For the right amount of money, would you eat a scorpion?
Never eat a scorpion.
A lot of your tantrums seem quite tongue-in-cheek, were they?
What do you mean, tongue-in-cheek?
Do you like dancing? Because you'd be quite good on one of those dance reality shows.
Yeah, I love dancing. I did all my ballet exams when I was little.
You like darts? Because you'd be quite good on a dart show if you got a bullseye. Something to do with throwing something.
Darts? What? Yeah, maybe.
Sorry, just... I think he's got the shits.
Well, all I can say is that you two are a formidable, lethal double act and no celebrity is safe, so really well done.
Mark's actually got a message for you, Mark, haven't you?
Oh, okay. That seems very nice. What did he say?
He just called you a massive twat.
I might have guessed. Ladies and gentlemen, Olivia Lee and Mark Nelson! They call America the home of the brave. And who better to test that theory than my next guest, Olivia Lee. Hello, gorgeous. Olivia, welcome to Balls of Steel. What have you been doing this week?
Well, I've been doing more in Hollywood.
Okay.
I wanted to make the most out of my time there. So as well as winding up celebrities, I thought I'd immerse myself into the world of producers and attain castings, Mark.
How exciting. Let's take a look.
For Hollywood stars, the red carpet is all about working the crowd and talking shit. So I'm going to interview them with a mic that tells it like it is. Wesley, we all know you as the hard man, but when you look in the mirror, what do you see?
Smooth chocolate.
Yeah, tastes good.
No, I don't know about that.
Foo Fighters, you're very busy, but what is it you like doing the most in your spare time?
Rocking the fuck out of stadiums all over the world.
Yes! Do you have any other hobbies?
No hobbies. What's your hobby?
My hobby? Talking to people like you and asking questions. To make it big in Tinseltown, a budding young actress has to go through the trying process of auditions. And when I go to an audition, it's usually trying for everyone involved. So I start.
Yeah. You start.
I'm going to just have a sherry.
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 I'm Mr. Krebs, so I'll start, all right? We just can't, okay? I'm old enough to be your father.
Yeah, we just can't, okay? I'm old enough to be your father.
No, that's wrong. That's my line that you just repeated. We just can't, okay? I'm old enough to be your father.
We just can't, okay? I'm old enough to be your father.
No, that's my line. Your line is the next line.
I'm sorry.
We just can't, okay? I'm old enough to be your father.
Yeah, we just can't, okay? I'm old enough to be your father.
Well, I just told you not to do that, and you just didn't do that for some reason. Remember, I just said, I have a line. We just can't, okay? I'm old enough to be your father. Then you say, so? I'm not a virgin, you know. Not by a long shot.
Are you not?
No, I'm reading the line of this.
Oh! I thought it was a bit weird you were just telling me that.
No.
What was it about you that you think really grabbed the producer's attention?
Oh, gosh, I think, if I recall...
They sniffed it out.
Right.
I say, you just can't, okay? I'm old enough to be your father. Then you say, so? I'm not a virgin, you know, not by a long shot.
I have a wife.
No, that's my line. You're messing this up. You're supposed to say, no, I'm not a virgin, you know, not by a long shot. And then I say, I have a wife.
I have a wife.
No, that's my that's what my next line
is. Oh, sorry.
How would you have a wife? Back up. Let's start again.
I have a wife.
No, I have a wife.
Do you?
No, I don't really have a wife. I'm trying to explain to you that you shouldn't be saying that line.
How does the William Shatner from Star Trek differ to the man who's standing in front of me now?
Well, 40 years makes a difference.
You smell great.
I smell great?
Yeah.
That's my wife.
That's why. It's your perfume.
Don't just say the words on the page. That doesn't make it acting.
I have a wife. Yeah. So should we read on a bit then,
no,
maybe?
No, I think we're good. I'm good. I definitely saw all I need to see.
LA or London?
Oh,
LA London. Or London? London. Roast beef or burgers?
Roast beef.
Anal or blowjobs?
Oh my god!
No?
Not appropriate.
We'll just put an answer in ourselves, yeah, or something. Yeah.
Don't put an answer for her.
No. It's alright, I'm more a fan of anal, really.
Now, that producer that was auditioning you,
yeah,
he must have got really irritated when you just repeated every line he said.
He must have got really irritated when I just repeated every line he said.
I think I can see where this is going.
I think I can see where this is going.
Ladies and gentlemen, Olivia Lee, Hollywood's worst nightmare!
Thank you!